Olympia Leisure Center, and there's a big event on this morning. There's the unveiling of the George Best statue.
Very good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen, and boys and girls. Welcome on this wonderful and long-awaited and much-anticipated event. It's just going to be an incredible day, and on behalf of Norman and Barbara McNary and all the organising team who have made this wonderful event happen, we'd like to welcome you here today. I was just playing some music there, and you might have been sitting saying we didn't know these songs or heard about them. He was so much of a hero and an icon for us in Northern Ireland, not just Northern Ireland, but around the world. And it's hard to believe there was 16 songs written about George Best. We managed to source about 12 out of the 16. We don't know where the other four went, but we tried our best, and that was just some of them, just to put you in the mood for the whole occasion. I'd like to hand you over now to start off the proceedings from BBC Northern Ireland Sport, Stephen Watson. Oh.
Thank you very much indeed, George. Thank you very much to all of you here for turning up this morning. But it's a pleasure and an honour to be here this morning to help host this very special unveiling ceremony. It's fantastic to see. We got a nice sunny day here at the Olympia Leisure Centre at the entrance to the National Stadium at Windsor Park for this very special unveiling of George's statue.
It was to bring. It was a road which took George to dizzying heights, but it was also at times to lonely and troubled lows. In July 1961, the road took George, just aged 15, from our family home in Burren Way to Old Trafford, leaving a huge gap in our lives. In December 2005, that road brought George back to our family home, from where he took his final journey to be laid to rest with our mum. At his funeral, I said, "Do not look on George as gone. He has merely stepped off the pitch." Prophetic words, as today I'm sure you'll agree that George is most definitely back on the pitch. And today, the road has brought our Belfast boy back to the city, the people, and the family he loved him most of all. Lovely words from George's family this morning to welcome you all here. Now, this statue obviously has been the inspiration of the company Lekeel, and one man in particular, and I would like to introduce you to him now. He'd like to say a few words. Please welcome Mr. Tony Curry.
Yo! First of all, I'd like to thank you all for attending. Great to see such a big crowd. And I hope everyone will be happy with the end result. Our aim from the start was to create a fitting tribute to a legend from Belfast and to remember George Best as he would have wanted to be remembered for the football. And symbolically, we placed him at ground level, not on a pedestal to be looked up to, but as a normal guy, an exceptionally talented footballer, a flawed genius. And fans can now interact with his statue and have their photos taken alongside him, as he did when he was alive. And of course, it's also to showcase the talents of myself and the team from Lekeel Bronze. And we hope that it'll bring more visitors and fans to the Olympia Leisure Centre and to this part of the city. I'd like to thank all who donated, and it's very much appreciated, every penny that was given to us. And I can assure you that every penny did go into it, as we can attest to. And from the very beginning, our friend Robert Kennedy has been behind us and has been in touch with media and Evan Little in particular was instrumental in getting us recognition, which we badly needed. I'd also like to thank the Daily Mirror, who gave us publicity as well, and the Belfast City Council for accepting the statue and placing it in such a prominent position where it will be seen by thousands.
Continuing legacy of George Best, thank you Barbara and Norman for inviting me, and of course I'm here, I would have done anything to be here. This poem is called A Statue for George. His foundations stand firmly above the Belfast Sleach. And apparently sleach means mud, ladies and gentlemen. I had to Google it earlier, but Barbara actually told me in the end. So, his foundations stand firmly above the Belfast Sleach. Those layers of time beneath our streets. This boy is home and owned by his whole city. His life was an open book. Everyone could share in his turmoil and learn from him. He wanted it that way. To those who loved him, we can only try to understand your love and your heartbreak. The stories of his kindness are many. A gesture, a hello, giving a moment of his time and respect to those who approached him. His image for this bronze rose in the east and now settles towards the west for everyone who remembers him. It will only be surpassed by his genius in our memories. And that's for Barbara and Norman. Thank you very much.
Kennedy, singer-songwriter, with a tribute poem from a fan.
Thank you very much, Brian. I think it's just testament to George to see such a good crowd here today for the unveiling of this statue. He's a truly wonderful ambassador to Northern Ireland, and I know that tens of thousands of people, not just coming to the football matches, but this will be a tourist stop, no doubt, for the rest of its days, as long as it's here. But it's time to unveil the statue, and to do that, I would like to ask Barbara and Pat and to Robert, who's a fan here this morning, if they could step forward to do the honours for us, please. Thank you very much indeed. Please give a big round of applause to Barbara, Robert and Pat. And there'll be lots of time for photographs afterwards as well. I'd just like to ask Pat to join me for a wee second, perhaps to say a few words. Pat, first of all, what do you make of the statue?
Beautiful. Yeah, I haven't had a chance. But as you know, we joined the international team the same night, way back 1964 against Wales, Betchfield, Swansea. I was at Watford at the time, hadn't come up against them in the first division. But as soon as you seen them in the training sessions, them round nutmegging the players, like, you thought, well, what a talent this lad's going to be. And of course he went on to be an unbelievable player.
I know you played alongside him, you also played against him. Sure, the few goals slotted past those hands of Pat Jennings.
I ended up looking at telly, that one I went out and mispunched, and I went to close him down, and somehow he managed to hook it over the top of me, and we had two players, Mike England and Phil Beale, go back in the line, and somehow he got it over the top of them as well. But that was something done every week. I mean, we've all seen the match against Chelsea, where he's gone through, Chopper Horace come across, nearly cut him in two. He rolled the tackle and Madon dropped the shoulder and sort of passed Peter Minetti. I mean, the present day footballers, I think they would have been still rolling over, you know. But that was great. And not only was he an unbelievable player, but you couldn't kick him out of it. I mean, if you kicked him, that was him. He would come back to me, Pat, whenever you get it, give it to me. I'd roll it to him outside the box and he would just run straight for whoever was kicking him. I mean, just incredible. I mean, I always refer back to the game against the Dutch team. At that time he was back at Fulham and the press were questioning whether he was good enough to come back and play at the national level. And that night against the great Dutch team, Neeskens ripped all the lot, Cruyff, and they put Neeskens on to do a man-for-man marking job. And they had nutmegged Neeskens about 6-7 times. Now Neeskens is trying to kick him. George has seen the tackle and come, got above him and come down on top of Neeskens. Neeskens on the floor moaning. George takes his tie up and says to Neeskens, here, tie them together. And we drew 2-2 for that great Dutch team. And they went on to play Argentina in the final of the World Cup the next year. 2-2 in Rotterdam that night. Unbelievable. That was George.
I know you made your international debut with George and you obviously saw his career flourish very closely. But as I said, he was a great ambassador for Northern Ireland and continues to be today.
Absolutely. I mean, we look at world-class players and Messi's of the day. That was George and his day. Nobody touched him. It's hard to judge players against each other. Impossible, really, when you look at Ronaldo, Messi nowadays. But George was right up there with the best of them.
He was the best of the lot, wasn't he?
And my one regret is from such a fantastic World Cup class player that unfortunately didn't get to make the World Cup for this. That's one regret for him. He didn't play in the 82, 86. Even if Billy had picked him for half an hour, would have loved to see him there. Yeah.
Here, here. I think we can all agree with that. Thank you very much for being here today. Thank you.
Statue unveiled in front of Olympia Leisure Centre, the winter 22nd of May 2019. Come and see it for yourself.